Okay, so we are live now, and welcome everybody to Anupad Book Club, to an evening of a spiritual talk with author Anu Chopra and I Indira Nityanaman. In conversation with Neena Singh, the project head with Anupad Book Club and writer herself. The stage is all yours.
Nina, you're muted. Nina, you're muted.
Sorry, apologies. Thank you, Neri, for the wonderful introduction. Greetings to all. Welcome to yet another wonderful episode with Ahmedabad Book Club. I'm Neena, your host for this evening in conversation on spirituality and the solutions that we find therein. This is a tale of travel to the city of solace, of moksha, a city where time tends to stand still as you are transported to another era, the mighty and purifying Ganga and the numerous ghats that she has on her banks, the destination, the last destination of a physical self, where people usually go towards the twilight years of their life. With me tonight are two authors. This is the collaborative work. She is a retired principal, a director of at Bhartiya Bhasha Sanskriti at Gujarat Vidyapeeth, a visiting faculty at Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, and presently at EDI Gandhinagar. She also is a lecturer at SAP. With 4 decades of teaching experience, she has 6 published books to her name, is a guide to MPhil and PhD scholars, and associate director, co-chairperson at Disamo. That's an NGO for the not so privileged children. An associate editor for Genosis, a literary journal. She has a keen interest in translation studies, especially from Tamil poetry into Gujarati, believing that translation has a lot to do with bridging chasm in our multilingual country. And India, we have, I think, more than 20 languages. She is now concentrating on Tamil Dalit novels and translating some really wonderful works into Gujarati. That is Dr. Indira Nityanandam.
Thank
Welcome,
you, Nina.
Indira.
Thank you.
And now, there's another spiritual seeker, a wonderful writer. She's a fiction writer in English. Her last book, Altitudinous, also co-authored of. It was a collaborative work of 10 lecturers, 10 authors, Indira Nityanandam also being one of them. That was a fiction thriller. Varanasi is their second collaborative work with the deep quest for a spiritual to find a deeper meaning of life. She has a very, very strong love for the four-legged kind. All kinds, not just dogs or cats. And she has deep love and caring for them. I think the love for these pure souls is what maybe puts us on the right spiritual track. She's a very, very keen mythologist, writes a lot on mythology, our ancient Indian history, the ancient stories from the Puranas and the Ramayana. She reads them all and she writes really, really wonderful articles, soul searching. She loves to teach at the NGOs and also not to the not so privileged ones, especially girls and women. She is Anu Chopra. Yes, only Anu. There is no Anuradha or anything. She is Anu Chopra.
Thank you.
Welcome to, welcome, welcome. Okay, I'll start with, I think it's usually among the mandates, mandates talking about the titles, Varana 6. A story of six, maybe troubled souls, people all around us. I think we respond to a very, very ordinary random ad in the newspaper. And this idea is, but we put everything in. I just stop and go to Banarasi, now also called as Banaras. That's an interesting name and strange that this batch had only six, which makes it very compact. and covers, I think, all that you both want to convey to the authors. So, why Varanasi only? Varanasi and not any other city? There are wonderful cities in the south too. Another, we have Char Dhams. Anu, what do you say?
So the thing is, I'm from Banaras. And it is like, I mean, when people tell me now, of course, with Modi ji and Banaras has become very clean. But at one point, it wasn't. So everybody would tell me, oh, how do you go? There's so many cows everywhere and there's so much. But I have never seen the dirt. I never felt that it was dirty. And then Indira went to Banaras and then I kind of said that she also liked Banaras very much. So that is how we started writing this novel. So for me, it is a spiritual city and my roots are there. So that is why I thought of writing this novel.
Indira, what's your...
Six Indian women, upper middle class, educated, urban. We had to put them somewhere. And you know, one of the usual choices, some of the usual choices were cities like Bangalore and Hyderabad and Pune, because they've become such IT hubs. And then we also needed a city which we knew, because if you're going to place our characters in a particular city and we want to describe the city, then we should know the places of the city, we should know the culture of the city. So we did spend a lot of time. But then Anu's roots being so clear and so firm in Banaras, Varanasi, Kashi, call it by any name, we thought that would be the ideal place. You don't have to go to Banaras to die. You can go to Banaras to live. That's what we decided. And as our progress is, Nina will probably tell you why our characters live. They don't die.
That is we'll talk about that later. You know, but I was also thinking about the characters that you've written. This is a work of fiction, but I do know that not, every story fiction is not really fiction, because the characters are always around us, you know. There's always somebody or the other we see living a life that we usually read in the books. Are you inspired totally? I'm sure many people must have inspired you, if not all.
Yeah. Of course, you see life around you, and that is how you write. That is why most women write about women, because they don't go out so much. So if you see, all women books are women centric only, because that's the only thing. I mean, that is so close to their hearts, their in-law, their mother-in-laws, their friends, their mothers, their sisters, their cousins. So yes, it is inspired by real women. But not totally, as they say, it doesn't bear any resemblance to living or dead. So, but it is inspired. A lot of like one character would be two people merged into one, like that way. Yes, of course, it's inspired. I mean, you are a writer too, Nina, so you know that.
Oh, but I cannot make up stories. I can only write what I see, and that's the reason I asked.
Okay.
I think the total fiction work is only fairy tales. But even they are not total fiction, because all the evil aunts and the angel kind of aunties, uncles, they're all around us.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
You know, I'd like to put it differently. I mean, to continue with what Anu said. So if you look at one character, right? She is basically someone we know, or we know someone like her, right? But she's not that character. And then within her, there are ever so many characters. So you can't look at her and say, well, this is Indira or this is Anu. You can't do that, because there are shades of Anu and shades of Indira and shades of Nina and shades of as many people you can think of. Because I think no writer writes in a vacuum, I believe. We all write somewhere. You know, so that somewhere, where is that somewhere that comes from our experience? It might not be my experience, but it might be an experience I heard about. So I bring that hearing, you know, or what we love to call vicarious experience. All books cannot be what I experienced. But there is a character, and we started discussing that character, and then we tell the other, Anu tells me, or I tell Anu, well, you know, she also, and then we bring in that shade also into the character. That's how our characters.
Are you muted? Nina, you're muted.
I'm listening.
Okay.
Because asking
so
in between
and that's how they developed.
Interesting. Before, I have quite a few questions, but before, I think I will, let's talk about all the characters, you know, troubled souls. I think we all go through it, like the story of, I will start with Jyoti and Rishabh later on. I think I'll discuss them later on because I found the end very, very intriguing, kind of Pied Piper.
Yeah.
The story of Kirti. There are many women like Kirti, you know, who are always healthy and perfectly capable of taking, you know, they take care of the house, the children, the decision makers in the family, and they're not used to asking help. You know, and when some illness hits them, you know, in her case, it was cancer, and when she thought she could lose it all, there is this denial of not wanting to ask help, you know. There is some kind of block which, you know, sometimes prevents you, like, why me, why me? A lot of women.
Yeah, Nina. Arthur Ashe, the famous tennis player, when he realized that he had some serious illness, is supposed to have said, why do we keep asking why me? Why don't we ask why not me? What is so special about me that I cannot get this disease? And all of us, our viewers, our listeners, three of us here, very recently a young 45-year-old actor, a very well-known actor and son of an actor, died. And he died when he was at the gym. So he was so fit, probably, right? But he had a heart attack when he was at the gym. So something's happening, something's wrong. So what you said, Nina, about this character, Kirti, and to be honest, she's based to a great extent on a cousin who I lost to cancer, a first cousin, a dear cousin. So the character is based on her, but she died, my cousin died, but my character lives. Because Anu and I, we had decided we want hope. We don't want despair. So as you mentioned, she comes to Banaras. And why does she come to Banaras? All six of our characters who are unrelated to each other, who are strangers to each other, see an ad, right? And find that the ad has exactly what they are looking for. Are you at a point of no return? Don't you are you wondering what to do with yourself? Have you lost the joy of living? Then come here. And they go there. And Nina, I want to say that our book is not fully spiritual, not at all spiritual. Because Anu and I, Anu is interested in spirituality, but we are very down to earth. So we are also looking at the possibility of finding your answers, not only externally, but also within yourself. I think many of us succeed in finding answers to our problems, solutions to our problems, if we learn to look within us. So Kirti has cancer. Kirti has a loving husband, two children. And yet she feels that, you know, she's become weak. And so coming to Banaras helps her.
Yeah, but good point, Indira, I know. But spirituality is not really about not being down to. I think if you're, what I said with the book is has spirituality. It's not a spiritual book, maybe, but it has spirituality because that's where you find the solution. And the path is different for every path is right, every method is right, and every solution is right if it suits you.
They do find.
Because what works, Hanji, what works for me might not work for you, and what works for you might not work for Indira. So I think that's.
Exactly. Yes.
There is no one path in spirituality. कि आप यही करोगे तो आपको मोक्ष मिलेगा ऐसा तो नहीं होता
है. Yeah. So there is spirituality because there are a lot of temples, but it is a thin line that you know runs through the novel, but it is not exactly like.
That was because they all attended the spiritual retreat.
Yeah.
The spiritual retreat, and that
with them reciting shlokas, going to temples, so that also, you know, there is a kind of a method to this. There's a discipline where they have to get up early. So all that is there is some spirituality, but not all. That's what.
And of course, the little girl Suparna. girls like all around, not just from rich family, and the loss of innocence, which is not always spoken of. It feels sad sometimes the girls cannot talk about it.
That is so true.
The so-called trusting uncles and the so-called, and they are, and sometimes I think even parents fail to realize, are bachi hai kuch nahi, but they march them for life.
That is true.
From a world to be so trusting, and that is shaken very badly by somebody you trust so much.
That is what we've done, Nina, the six characters in our book. In fact, we had more characters and then gradually we cut them down to six because we didn't want it to be too meandering. We wanted some focus. So each one of those characters has a particular, the character raises a particular social issue, I think. Basically in reference to our country, I could say. It might be worldwide, but we are focusing on the major social issues of our country. So we mentioned one is a woman falling sick, and we spoke about cancer. The second, because you have mentioned that I'm talking about it, not necessarily in order of importance, but the second,
right.
The second issue that we have is about, you know, a child molestation by someone close to the family, someone within the family. We know that's where it happens.
And it happens all the time, but nobody talks about it. It happens all the time in cousins, in joint families. But
I think that's father's the sad
friends,
part.
Father's friends, you know, it could be them. So, and then it's hushed. And probably she never had the courage. Our Suparna as a kid never had the courage to tell her parents. I mean, we haven't looked at that aspect. But
because sometimes... But it mars them, it scars them for life, you know. And
absolutely.
Nobody believes that a bachi hai, kuch bhi bol rahi hai. Bol ke chup kara dete hai. And I, sometimes I find it strange. The parents fail to see that, you know. Understand that something is not right somewhere with the child. How can you be so trusting of
uncles,
your friends, you know, your brothers or your... That's sad. And of course, Damini...
And Suparna, let me finish. So Suparna grows up with that scar, Nina. And she does, she stays away from boys, but then she finally falls in love. But somewhere that, you know, childhood thing comes in between. And she can't continue with her love for that boy who loves her so much. So you're lost for life, you know, your future is killed for you. I mean, that's what hurt us so much when we were working on Suparna.
Yeah, I think that is sad part because she was just normalizing and becoming a normal, pretty young girl.
Yeah.
Very confident and...
Well-to-do.
Very well-to-do. And she's successful in her career. And
yet...
Something happens, yes. And then that's a sad part. Mm-hmm. And of course, we have Daminis. Not just in the film world. I think they're all around who don't want to accept we're getting old. I mean, it's of course easy to say it's all in the mind, age is a number.
But it's difficult to accept for many people. That is why the Botox industry and everything is thriving. Why are you making Why are you making that face?
No. What I meant? Not just Botox and these over-exercising. People say gym jaate hain. Fit hona aur sahi tarike se fit. They two different things, you know.
That is
just because you're
this young actor who died. They said ki people are so much into gymming that they that their heart it takes a toll on their heart. So being perfect body.
Because they will eat only what the dietitian says, what the gym is. They will lie. That's a very very.
Like quinoa and all, they are so alien to our culture, but everybody's into eating quinoa and various other things.
I know, broccoli, yaar, apne, what's wrong with our full cauliflowers?
Apna cauliflower bhi to achha hi hai.
Very good. We Indians are root eaters.
Yeah.
So, Nina,
can I interrupt? A friend wants to know how she enters the live thing. What should she do?
Join the Facebook club on Facebook.
She has to
Ahmedabad.
Be a member? Does she have to be a member?
Let her like the Ahmedabad Book Club page on Facebook.
All right.
Just tell her to like and then she can see us like there.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, please. Sorry.
CB, your and of course, one topic. Of course, there is a Dr. Meetu with the. How do you blame, you know, these doctors? I don't blame her for feeling, but she's a doctor by profession. And a lot she's doing because maybe she's supposed to, you know. कहते ना घोड़ा अगर घास से दोस्ती करेगा तो खाएगा क्या?
Actually,
but
actually, I had a maid, I mean a helper, house helper. Sorry, that's an inappropriate word now. So she had two daughters. She was a Rebari's daughter, and she had two daughters. And then for the second child also, she went to the gaon. There was a doctor whom she paid 25,000 and who did a sex determination test, but it must have been rubbish because she got another daughter. So then she went to another doctor again who said a sex determination test, and it was a boy. So these things are very rampant, and I don't blame this girl because she was a young girl, like she was barely 25 by the time she had all her three children. I don't blame her because in their community, I think they do not get inheritance if they have girls only. So there's so many, you know, there's so many socio-economic things to this this female feticide. So I guess she started by being kind to somebody and then...
Yeah, that's, I think maybe it starts by being helping out. Because when you already have two, three daughters, you can understand maybe they don't want another.
Yeah.
If it is another child, then let it be male.
So I also know a very rich joint family thing. So the younger one had a son and a daughter, and she got pregnant again. So the elder one had two daughters. So she asked some close friend and said, "Will you do a sex determination test? Because if she has a son, I'll adopt the son." But the doctor refused to do it. So I don't know what happened later. So I guess she aborted herself. So this is really common in whether lower socioeconomic or higher socioeconomic.
No, the point here is the guilt that she feels when her own daughter is going, and she takes it very, very personally that it's my bad karma which my daughter is
exactly.
suffering, you know, for facing. So that I think possibly
that is why she goes to Banaras to find some salvation for her. She does a lot of soul searching and then she realizes.
I think in all, there's also the Meetu. I think Meetu is a very quintessential mom who live only for their family, especially the children.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, if the one child dies, they just, they don't mean it, but they fail to neglect, take care of their second child who's well and alive, you know.
Yeah.
I've seen that happening, you know.
Nina, can we ask Anu to sort of give us in three or four sentences the story?
Yeah.
Because many of our listeners might not know the story at all. Meetu's story, for example.
Or
even the doctor's story. You know, I think, Anu, we should, so that people who have not read the book can also appreciate our characters. Anu, I think we should do that. What do you say, Nina? Yeah.
Meetu is a middle child. So she's always been kind of neglected. Because she's been a middle daughter, and then she gets married, and then of course she lives for her sons, and she has two sons, and her husband is a powerful politician, but the son decides to marry a widow with a child. So that was absolute no-no for the father, because obviously they had he had strong ambitions and he didn't want this to happen. And he blamed the mother and the son for falling in love with, according to him, a very unsuitable woman. And the son was so, and he also hurled abuses at his wife and also son was so shocked that he said, "I'm getting better and better," and he just committed suicide. This is so, and then she's so much into her grief that she neglects her second son. And then she sees this ad and then she decides to go to Banaras.
Found out. I purposely left one for the end, Anju, you know, which is actually there are many like Anju who have, I mean, they have such a lot of love in the family till the parents realize the one quality. And how does it change, you know, whether you like a man or a woman? Love is still love, you know. But when you have a heart full of love and they just abandon for what? Why? She is because they like. She confessed that she's a lesbian. How does it change the person? Does it make her less of a daughter? Less of a human being?
But parents don't realize that. They marrying somebody unsuitable, falling in love with the same gender. I mean, as parents, it's very difficult to accept. Now, with everybody opening up, like a lot of people opening up that my mother's accepted me, and a lot of celebs coming out that they are gay, like Devdutt Patnaik and all, they openly say they are gay. So then I guess now perceptions are changing, but still it's very difficult.
Very slowly, very slowly.
I think we should thank Manvendra, Prince Manvendra Gohil also for coming out.
Yes, yes.
Because in the royal family too, come out is very, very...
Yeah. Absolutely.
But still, I think in the ordinary families, okay, family name... I think if the child confesses to the parent, where is the need for parents to broadcast it to the world? And tell them, you know, that we can't accept a son or a daughter because he or she is a gay or a lesbian. They're working, they're successful, let them be.
Yeah, but it's tough for the parents.
I know.
They want to, I mean, legitimize how...
I know. The point is, see, the world doesn't know. Suppose you XYZ your child, only you would know. The world sees the child as a successful person, a daughter of Anu, or maybe daughter of Indira, or XYZ. So to abandon a child, you know, to when they, I think they need the parents the most.
Yeah.
That is, I think, can be, what can be worse?
I think in our society, we are always bajuwale. बाजू वाले क्या बोले मासी क्या बोलेगी मोनी क्या बोलेगी
दैट
आई थिंक नीना इज हैविंग प्रॉब्लम्स विद नेटवर्क नीना
नो
इज
इट नो नो नॉट एट ऑल
नो नो आई एम लिस्टिंग एक्चुअली यू आर सपोज्ड टू टॉक आई एम जस्ट हम्बल कन्वर्सेशनलिस्ट
यू आर हेजी
ओके ऑलराइट No, for me, Nina is going that round thing na, which buffering jo hota hai. Mere ko Nina ke chehre pe buffering dikh raha hai.
Nahi, nahi, Indra, Nina, she's okay. Indra, you are very hazy.
That's okay. Okay, let's talk about the main characters. The ad makers, Jyoti and Risha.
So they are my
Such
favorite.
A wonderful... Yeah, because...
They are after
That's how it started. They are the ones who started the retreat. There are many like us who decide to live, not to be bogged down by whatever happens. And they fight it on their own. They make it on their own. They choose their life.
Yeah.
And, what is collaborative writing, Nina? I must admit that I gave them a face or a whatever to Rishabh and Jyoti. And then towards the end, it was totally Anu who decided what should happen to them. You know, they are there at the beginning of the book and then they are there at the end of the book. So let me say I did the beginning, but she did the end because both of us are very good friends. We also know what we are capable of or how we think. Like I would want it to move in the direction of realism and Anu would want it to move in the direction of surrealism. So it begins as a very realistic novel. And then after a month, you know what happens. So it has been fun creating these characters, Rishabh and Jyoti. And for those of you who haven't read the book, let me just say that these are the two who run this Abhyantara, which is that place. They don't even like to call it an ashram, though the locals call it an ashram.
It's a spiritual retreat center. That's what I understood.
It's a place. It's a place where you go when you have nowhere to go. So as we say in the novel, I need a place to sit. I need a shoulder on which I can place my head and cry. I need a meal for tomorrow and I don't know where to go. So these were how women began coming there. And for our listeners, viewers, non-readers as yet, they are Jyoti and Rishabh. But what is their relationship? We have left that also without really clarifying.
There's no need to. I personally understood when I read the book that they are spiritual souls and they are there genuine to help people around. But then it gives you a feeling of maybe there's a sequel to come, because they just disappear like the Pied Pipers, and nobody knows where the children went. There've been numerous stories later on, you know, they were found and happy. So that was quite intriguing, you know. And six women who make a last visit to the Abhyantra, and they sit there and meditate for some time. And each has their own different experience, wherein they feel the presence of Jyoti and Rishabh. I think that was wonderful. But as you said, you know, it's not easy in a collaborative work, or no matter how like-minded, how open-minded you might be, because they're bound to be different in opinions and thought processes. So how cohesive, you know, to make it cohesive and conducive to put it on print and to bring about the book, your ideas?
No, it was quite a cohesive thing. I don't think we really fought. We should have, but we didn't fight. And even after the book was released, we're still as good friends as ever. But no major fights, because we were kind of, we were on the same wavelength. Yeah, strangely, but we didn't fight at all. I mean,
Unlike Altitudinous, where you had 10 of you, you know, for...
Altitudinous, there were a lot of disagreements and a lot of this thing. We were 10 people, but here, because we were just two and we knew exactly what we wanted. So it was not, I think we were on the same wavelength.
Also, Nina, I want to say that in Altitudinous, we were all strangers to each other. Except, you know, Anu and me, somebody knew somebody probably, but all 10 of us didn't know each other. Whereas here, Anu and me, we have known each other for donkey's years, right? So we know exactly how we think, what we like, what we don't like, you know? And then we'd say, okay, you take care of this, I'll take care of that. So there was absolutely no issue at all in bringing this book together, I think. And as Anu says, we are still friends, I think. So that proves it.
Open up that how cohesive your work must have been. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Which is your favorite part of the book? Tell me that. Anu?
My favorite part of the book is the end, because there is no end. It's just left in the... Mm-hmm. It's just left to the reader's imagination. So that is my favorite part of the book, actually.
Indira?
Actually, my favorite part of the book is walking through Benares. In fact, when we wrote the book, of course, we had an editor, and I must thank her, Panki, a young girl who did the editing for us. But when we wrote the book, initially, before the editing, Anu and me had so much more of Benares in it. We went to all the temples, and then, Anu, what are they called? Who bring that water? Anu? Pani jo leke aate.
Parihari?
No.
Nahi. Kavari? Kavariya or something. You know, they bring water.
Not Kavariya or something. It is Kavariya. And then, you know, there are these women. So the thing is that they get water from Allahabad Prayagji, and they pour it on the Shivling here, the main temple. And the people who don't even take off their Kavariyas at all, they are called some. They're called bums. I think bum, they go. So they are, as soon as they come, everybody gives way to them. But now there are a lot of women also who are doing it. But of course, some of them stop on the way and do it. But so this was the first time during COVID, it was a big thing that they are not allowing the Kavariya Yatra. But now they're
starting. So we had that. Because Anu is from Benares, we knew all the temples. So we went to the Hanuman temple also. We went to the Devi temple also. We sat through the Aarti. I mean, we means our characters. So we had moved. So to me, that Benares coming alive, especially as Anu mentioned, I'd just been to Benares and come back and watching the Ganga Aarti from a nav, from a boat upstream. Oh my God. So to me, it is Benares coming alive.
That experience is divine. Because Benares is said, Benares ke to kan kan mein Mahadev hai. Even the air kind of breathes, you know, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, like
Because
it
any
is.
temple you go, I mean, and also they say that in the night Shivji walks and he gives Amrit to everybody, like people who are dead, so that they go straight away to heaven. Like he's walking in the night in the, that's his city actually.
On the Ghats, yes.
Yeah.
So did you both, I mean, understood that you've been working, you had a very, very good rapport and collaboration. So did you both race to finish the
No, no,
book
no.
or you went leisurely and slow?
No, we were
I know.
slow and steady and we were at a pace, and Indra was working. I was also busy with something. We were at a pace, but we enjoyed it a lot.
So there was sometime 1 month, like we'd meet every week and we'd talk about the book. Then maybe 2, 3 months, we won't be able to do
Yeah.
anything because we have guests or there's a wedding in the family, you know, and all that. So all that happened. We never put any pressure on each other to complete the book. We knew we had to complete the book. We knew we will complete the book, and we're already planning another, Nina. So the next book
Oh.
also we'll collaborate. But that's a secret, of course. We won't let you into it now, but
No, we won't take the fast suspense away. Okay, which scene or character which maybe stuck you among all your six characters, and of course Jyoti and Rishabh, which scene or a character which maybe stuck you the most, which maybe also you can relate to?
So what I liked, what I really thought about Meetu was that the only me time she got was when she was in the bathroom, which is a thing with, for a lot of women. The only me time they get is, you know, when they are in the, because they're always doing something or the other, working, you know, listening to their children, husbands, in-laws. So that was one thing that really struck me, because somebody did tell me that one of my old aunts that I used to spend so much time in the bathroom because that was the time I was away from all the, so that was something which what my aunt told me, then I used it for me too, and that really like rings a bell, like I feel
Hey, Mira.
For me, it's the first page of Damini's, the chapter on Damini. Damini, my dear friends, is the artist, is the actor who's now too old and doesn't get any heroine roles. So it begins with Damini walking down the red carpet and people cheering her and all that. And she lifts her hand to throw a kiss. To wave a kiss or throw a kiss, whatever actresses do. And when her hand goes up, it hits something on the table, on her bedside table, and she realizes that it was all a dream. It wasn't really happening. To me, it's one of those, to me, very touching that, you know, how we continue to live in a dream world in the past without accepting reality. All of us, I think, are guilty of it at some stage or the other.
I think especially when you've been very, very successful in life, to come down from the pinnacle is not easy. Especially when
True.
you've touched stardom and you have everybody, you know, running and at your beck and call and fulfilling all your desires before you ask them. And to
True,
lose
true.
that and suddenly, so I guess it's not easy. Not just in the movies, I think it's everywhere.
True.
When you're used to getting everything on hand and you lose all that, it's not easy, you know. Especially when one is not prepared, one always is driving in cars and you're not ever being taught to walk on the roads, it can be very, very difficult.
Absolutely.
True.
True, true.
Yeah. So do you both have a role model or a spiritual soul guide,
So my
or
spiritual guide
the
is only. I feel that when I'm really in trouble, he opens his sword and at me and things are going to be fine. So my spiritual guide is Shivji only. But now that since I since because of YouTube and things, I listen to Shivani sometimes. But Shivani and Sadhguru. But then I know people are very anti Baba Ramdev. But his discourse on meditation and
Oh.
Om chanting, and then Gayatri mantra, that uchcharan, that really like just makes me very happy.
No.
You know,
Baba
everything.
Ramdev, when it comes to yoga, he definitely is an expert.
I'm talking
मैं
about
सूर्य
मेडिटेशन.
नमस्कार भी, मैं तो उन्हीं के वीडियो देख के सूर्य नमस्कार आई प्रैक्टिस
And I've got very bad
पानी.
arthritis and okay, not as a but I just watch his videos to you know to get my body little and
No, थोड़ा इवन आई वी ऑल हैव आई थिंक बिट ऑफ नी प्रॉब्लम, शोल्डर प्रॉब्लम, बोन्स दिस एज एंड दिस एक्सरसाइज. आई एम बीइंग एस्थमेटिक, आई यूज डू द भ्रामरी एंड यू नो अलोम विलोम
And
विद
now
द गायत्री
especially
मंत्र टू. या
more
इट हेल्प्स.
asthmatic because the weather is changing right now. So
या आई डोंट हैव क्रोनिक प्रॉब्लम इट्स इवन सो दिस. बाबा रामदेव के मैंने काफी देखे हैं, दे हैव रियली रियली बीन हेल्पफुल, स्पेशली व्हेन यू नो माय माय बुआ वाज फिजिकल ट्रेन्ड अ टीचर, बट इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज यू नो लाइक इजी. लाइक पहले वहीं से सीखा था, बट डेफिनेटली यू नो दिस. बट यस, फॉर मी एज अनु, महादेव जी इज माई फर्स्ट स्पिरिचुअल गाइड, माई गुरु, ऑल्सो द फर्स्ट योगी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. He is the one who taught us yoga, gave us the sound of Om. Inira, what about you?
To be honest, I don't have a guru. Fortunately or unfortunately, my parents taught me not to believe in God, men, I think. So I don't have, but I
No,
have my God
I.
and me. I have my God and me. And then I don't even have a favorite God. I know there is a Kuldev and there is a. So my God is anthropomorphic. I'm not looking at a God who doesn't have shape. I'm too much of a Hindu. So my God is human. I mean, is it a human form? But I don't have a favorite God.
No,
And
I just said role model. My question
I can
was
canvas. No, I'm saying two things. I got your question. So
okay.
I don't have a guru. I don't have a spiritual guru because somehow that's how my parents. I'm religious. I believe in God tremendously. And he's the only one who can solve our problems when you have no one else to look up to. But my God and me is a very direct kind of a contract that I have with my God. So I don't need anyone. And if you ask who is your icon, who is your role model, I think it's my dad, my late dad. I've learned so much. All of
That's
us, of course, love our parents and all that, but my father was a single parent because my mom died very young. So I think I owe a great deal to him. So I think of him as my, though he'd be shocked, I mean, from heaven if he's listening to me,
no.
no, but I think he's my role model. If I could do even half of what he could do, and he was not a great, successful, you know, top of the world kind of the person, but to me, he was an ideal human being. And probably
Okay,
Anu will agree to some extent because she knows my dad.
why would he be shocked, possibly laughing that what made
No,
this girl say
maybe
it after so long? पहले
laughing.
बोलती तो अच्छा था, she's saying it now. No, that was such a wonderful thing to say, because see, people usually when we talk of spiritual guidance or guru, it's not always the God men. Our guides are spiritual, our role models can also be people around you.
Yes,
Even the
absolutely.
underprivileged, sometimes you learn from them.
I want to add a little bit to what you and Anu were saying earlier, but I think pranayam, for example, yoga, has in many ways helped me grow as an individual. Because I began yoga quite late in life, but after I began my pranayam, my anulom and vilom, very simply, I think it has helped me grow in many ways, you know. Grow within me, grow positively, grow
It
internally.
definitely helped me these days with my bad cough and cold. That definitely helped me. If you both could live in anywhere else or
Any?
any other city in the world, if you could live anywhere else, where? Varanasi?
I'm happy where I am.
Ahmedabad?
Absolutely. Wherever I am at
Hello.
that moment, that's the best place to be. And I've lived in many towns of India. But I think where I am now is the best to be now. So I am,
Hello.
oh, I wish I were in Switzerland. I don't have that feeling.
I
Yeah,
would like to
lovely to
live
go
in
for
Switzerland. I would like to
lovely
live
to
in.
go for a holiday, but sorry, Anu. Sorry.
I would like to live in a ba in Banaras, somewhere near the Ganges, but that is a dream, so I don't know.
No,
Apnu, Ahmedabad.
I too have traveled all over, benefits of being a army officer's daughter, but up to Pakka Ahmedabad. The city just called me and it never let me go.
True, true.
That's
for
a
most
thing
of
about
us.
for all those who are living. I think every city has a calling for everybody. So jo jahan settle hai, but yes. I have yet to go to Banaras, but Mahadev doesn't call me. So whenever, let's see. वैसे दर्शन देते हैं सर क्या प्रॉब्लम यू डोंट नीड टू कम देयर सो व्हेन यू बोथ रोट द बुक व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ इंपैक्ट डू यू थिंक योर बुक विल लीव ऑन द रीडर्स डू यू थिंक व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ इंपैक्ट विल योर बुक हैव ऑन द रीडर्स
आई वाजंट थिंकिंग ऑफ दैट आई वाज जस्ट थिंकिंग ऑफ जस्ट राइटिंग दिस बुक एंड टेलिंग पीपल दैट Well, there is hope always, but I wasn't really thinking that it would make any. I wasn't thinking of it as an impactful novel. I was just thinking of it as a very readable novel, but not impactful. But maybe it has become impactful as some of the reviews I get from friends. So
I think the only message, not that it's going to be a bestseller, or we didn't think about it. Both of us were very clear that we wanted our book published. But I think the message that we want to leave for all our readers is that finally the answers come from within.
Yes.
You need answers, learn to look within.
Yeah, that is true.
Everything is within us. You just have to look.
Yes.
The good, the bad, the ugly.
Everything.
The divine and the demons, it's all there within us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. We are the divine, we are the demons.
Yeah, that is true.
It's all
within us.
I think maybe listen to your heart. Heart is single, you know, mind is bipolar. It is right and wrong, good and bad. So, but yes, I think the book should leave a good impact to whosoever reads it.
Thank you so much.
It's simple. The best part is because the book, you've written it very simply for everyone to understand. Yes. Minus all the big, heavy duty words or thoughts, you know.
Yeah.
The, whatever you're trying to convey has been put in very, very simply and very, very effectively, you know. So it's not the women just who go to trauma. Even the men go through it. Even the men
but
who read it will. Yeah, it's a women-centric, but see, problem has nothing to do with trauma, pain, loss. Or even molestation has nothing to do with being male or a female. Men go through it as much. Only they're trained not, especially in India, they're trained not to talk about it.
Yes, yes.
Stardom hits them also, you know, pampering. Hits them the most.
Yeah.
They're not used to listening to a no. I think that's one of the problems when they face when they get married. Because not every woman in the wife will agree, you know. And they're not used to listening to a no. So I think that should, you know. But still, if you could change anything, anything if you could want to change to accomplish the book again, would you?
What, the book?
No,
about the book?
Yeah.
No.
Would you change anything if you could accomplish?
Not really.
No more extra characters or
we had
no drama.
But our editor said it would become too long drawn, which I agree because it wouldn't have been so compact. We both had extra characters, but no, I wouldn't want to change anything about the book.
Yeah, I think that's fine because you're the six characters and the main protagonist.
Yeah,
Jyoti and Rishabh, they convey pretty much every emotion and feelings that one goes through in all the traumas and the social and the domestic problems which we all face some or the other time in our lives.
Right.
I think that was have you both done something like this? Or does it remind you of Have you both done something like this? Been to a retreat? See, spiritual retreats are of many kinds.
Yeah.
You don't always go to retreat because you have a trauma or a problem. Sometimes we just go to meditate, you know, just be a part of it. Because a collective meditation has a lot of a spiritual and a positive impact. I have done that, you know, especially during the COVID times. When you are doing collective meditation and sending out healing to the world, it's not just necessarily that you have a trauma or have you both ever been to a retreat?
No, not really. Not me.
I haven't.
Never been?
No.
Never been.
Oh, maybe you should sometime.
Yeah, we will now.
No.
Anu together? Anu yeah. together?
Why not?
Why not?
No, and then we'll sit and plan the next book there.
No, there you will not plan because you at a retreat you will be so much at peace. Maybe you'll definitely get ideas. That is a wonderful, really, really wonderful experience. It was so wonderful talking to you. We are time bound. Okay. But yes, is there something that you would like to add on?
Buy the book, read the book, review the book.
Read the book. Read the book.
It was absolutely, absolutely wonderful talking to you. There's still so much to talk. But then we would be giving away the book totally.
Yes.
I would like us, all our viewers and readers, to be very intrigued and by the title and I would want them to want to read the book and find out what all the other characters in the book are about, what the book is about.
Available
we all know
on
what
Kindle.
It's available on Kindle.
Yes.
Okay, no hard copies as yet.
No, we have hard copies, but we haven't placed them on any book store.
Not on Amazon or anywhere?
No, it is on what Amazon.
It's on.
Okay. So those who want to buy the book, Varanasi is on Kindle, is also on Amazon. I would love to thank you both and all the viewers on behalf of Ahmedabad Book Club. Ahmedabad Book Club is... It's a book club for readers and writers and of all kinds. It's a place where we sit and discuss. We review books and also what you read from them, what you sustain from them.
Right.
This initiative was started by Priyanshi Patel and Khurshid Rabji, the good writers themselves. And we also, it's a platform to budding artists, to poets, wherein you can talk and discuss on books. We promote them. Some people have this misconception, we are not event managers or organizers, and we do not sell. We're just a book club for book lovers. We recently had some book launch, about 10-year-olds. They've written such wonderful books. Yes. Poetry is by 17-year-old, 16-year-old. I think a lot of talent. So on behalf of Ahmedabad Book Club, to all my viewers, readers, thank you for being here. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Nina.
Thank you for being a part. It was wonderful talk. It was awesome.
Thank you for inviting us. And I hope our viewers and members of the Ahmedabad Book Club will buy our book and get back to us. You can also review it on Amazon. You can also
thank you.
We will do that. It was wonderful having you on the show.
Thank
and
you.
Waiting for your third book.
Okay,
another collaborating.
Happy Diwali to everybody.
I was going to say that from Ahmedabad Book Club. We're also going global now. We started in Dubai. We hope to have India mein to hai. We hope to have start the book clubs in every maybe country in the world.
Okay.
Hoping to inculcate the habit of reading. We hope to inculcate the habit of reading and writing in everyone.
All the best. All the best.
My viewers, Anu Chopra and Indira Nityanandam, wish you both a very, very happy Diwali.
Thank you.
Books, all your books with the firecrackers, with the diyas. No, not the crackers. Everybody, not just vibrant, illuminate. Illuminate your soul, illuminate your mind, illuminate darkness. From your mind, illuminate everything around you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nina.
Happy
thank
Diwali.
So
bye bye. Happy New Year to all of us.
Happy Diwali.
Bye
bye.
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 Bye.